Good morning.
Sorry.
Oh my God, everybody's really loud. Is it dark in here?
No.
Oh, I did that wrong.
Okay, oh, we're gonna, okay. Got it.
There we go, all right. Happy Sunday, everyone. All right, my chair is so far away from his. Now, I'm here to help you help me introduce my friend and yours, a man I met a long time ago, it seems like, who, when I first met him, he opened his home to me, gave me a place to sleep. He wasn't there. He was off somewhere, and he still let me stay in his house. He was a great guy. Honestly, there was a VHS. That's how long ago it was. VHS tape sitting on the coffee table. It said, "Watch me." I put it in his VHS thing, and there's a camera, and him, going, "Hey, welcome to my home. Follow me. I'll show you around." And He walked around his house. He's like, now this door sticks, so whenever you open it, you gotta pick it up and push it out. And there you go. Make sure you do the reverse when you lock it. And that's how I met Mr. Nathan Fillion!
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'll pull this shit over.
Why don't we pull that chair over here and do
always ordering me around.
Good morning. That's good. Whew. How many people have never been to Nerd HQ? You guys are in for a treat. How many of you guys have already been to Nerd HQ? Remember that? Good times. Wow.
Whew. You know how you can tell it's Sunday?
What?
Because I'm wearing really nice clothes.
Your best.
I know. These are the clothes that I packed, like, why did I pack that? Why would I pack a sweater vest?
When I first started working with Alan, wherever we went, oh, it's a little lunch. Oh, the cast is getting together for a brunch. Oh, there's a dinner. Oh, there's a read-through. He always wore a suit.
Good old days.
Wow. That guy's classy. He kind of acts a little odd, but I can't deny he's wearing the hell out of that suit.
Used to have a lot of suits.
Yeah, nice suits. Nice suits. Not like an Army and Navy, you know, Goodwill hunting.
No, they weren't. No bathing suits.
No.
No leisure suits.
No birthday suits.
No.
Trust me, it's for the best. The eyes can only take so much brightness.
It's a ginger skin thing, I understand.
Gingivitis.
So how has your con been?
Highlights of my con.
Yes.
Donning a disguise from covering my entire face, hitting the floor, shopping, doing a little looking around, nice. Taking some pictures of some amazing costumes, being recognized 3 times. What? Mr. Fillion, you do have a particular gait. That's true. I do. Highlight, yesterday, you hosted a bunch of panels here on Friday.
Yes.
I hosted a bunch of panels on Saturday.
Yes.
Joss Whedon, starting with his panel. Always entertaining and amazing.
Never heard of him.
Sure he's good. Every time I hear that man speak, publicly especially, on the spot, I go, wow, he's so much smarter than me. But he never rubs it in your face. I'm smarter than you. It's a gift.
Yeah, no, he is.
Then I did the Thrilling Adventure Hour panel.
Cool.
There was a kick-ass panel, which was kick-ass. And the Thrilling Adventure Power, thrilling.
My friend's in kick-ass.
Yes, Andy Nyman.
My friend, Andy Nyman. Andy Nyman. He was in Death at a Funeral movie that I did a while ago.
Is he dead? Call his name. What's his name? I don't know his name. Try Philip.
Yeah, that's Andy.
That's him. Then Evangeline Lilly came by. She was so charming and lovely. What a nice lady. Just what a great day. What a great day.
That's a lot of really, really nice people. Is Evangeline Lilly married?
Yes, I believe so, yes.
Congratulations to her.
So here we are. Was anybody here at my panel last year? Not here, but the other one. All right, so I'm gonna use a lot of the same jokes. If that's cool with you. Holy, let's get started.
Yeah.
Does anybody have like a burning, why don't you do this? You're hosting.
Does anybody have a burning feeling in their chest area, on their boobs?
Not a rash.
Not a rash.
An emotional.
Oh, a burning emotional desire.
To know
what Nathan's gonna say next.
That works. We can work with this.
Yes.
We can maybe even field some questions.
Do you have a burning desire to ask some questions about Fields? They're gonna pass microphones right there.
Hello.
Hi.
You recently said in an interview that you were okay not being attached with anything Marvel right now because you're very busy and
yes. You
only get 2 months of vacation from Castle.
Yes.
But you've also said multiple times that if Joss calls you and asks you to do something, you'll automatically say yes.
That's a rule.
So if Joss calls you and says, hey, Nathan, do you want to be in Avengers 2 Age of Ultron? You say...
I'd say, you're already filming that and you've already cast it. So what kind of mind game are you pulling with me, mister? That's just mean. And why would you do that to me? I thought we were friends. Let's be friends again. Let's stop fighting. You know what I have here, you guys? That was an excellent question. A bag of what?
Bag of shit.
Silly rabbit. Chicks are for kids. I snatched up some crap from around home. And I thought I'd bring it here and maybe try to raise some more money for Operation Smile.
I've never seen that book. This is what I was talking about.
You've
with the burning desire.
Book?
Naked Heat. That's the burning desire thing. Oh.
Alan, how many friends do you have on the New York Times bestseller list? Multiple times? Boom.
Wow, I gotta start reading.
Me, zing. This guy.
Nice.
Weird, right?
That is awesome.
Yeah.
Naked Heat.
I'm gonna sign that. So are you, Alan. You
really?
Sign that. Yeah, what the hell?
Does that make me on the Times bestseller list too?
Yep. That's the law.
All right.
I think for Operation Smile, that is worth $20. Would anyone give me $20 for that? Would anyone give me 40? 50? 60? 70?
200!
Jesus. That'll do. We'll arrange that. Where's the next question coming from? Hello, young lady.
Hello. Stana has mentioned a few times things.
Hold up. One second.
Yes.
Are you Canadian?
No, I'm from Seattle, but I've spent enough time in Vancouver.
Just
I
a fan.
Qualify for citizenship.
Just a Canadian fan.
Yes. Go nuts. Stana's mentioned a few times what she wants for Beckett in the future. Have you ever thought about what you want for Castle, or do you just kind of wait and see what comes your way?
Superpowers. The ability to go back in time 7 seconds. To erase a single mistake. Or try a better joke. That would be a good power. Like when a joke falls flat, ooh. You know what would be better? Try this one.
No one would know what you're talking about because you just start saying, oh, you know what would be better? Better than what?
In time, that would go internally.
Okay.
And I would get better at that. Right. You know what would be better? This joke, if I could go back 7 seconds. Here's what I have next in my bag of crap. I like this level. I'm really into this electric car. It's a three-wheeled spaceship of a car by this little company called Arkimoto.
Yep.
In Eugene, Oregon.
I drove it.
Welcome to the future, bitches. This is a Banana Republic 100% Pima cotton. Large.
That Pima cotton, that doesn't come cheap. That's the good stuff.
Do you have any idea the shipping costs from here to Pima? I'd say that shirt is worth
$20. Yeah, $20.
That's $100. Will anyone give me $120?
$120.
Wow. How much? 40? 140. Good, don't go backwards. This is good.
140.
150? How much? 150, oh, we got 150 already. We got 155. 160, you know what? I'm gonna let it sit at 160, you ready? Let's just let it sit at 160. Did you
sit
sign
on
that?
It at 160, I signed it.
There you go.
There you go.
Who's got the next burning rash?
If you could time travel any time, just once, when would you go? And why?
Oh, this is gonna sound really corny. But last night we were watching Serenity and I was going, oh my God, that was so much fun. No, I can't. I'd go kill Hitler. And miss out on Serenity again. Thanks, Hitler. Man, you're a dick. All right, I got a shirt here. I'm pretty sure I got this from Comic-Con last year. I'm pretty well versed in geek stuff. I don't know what this is. It's a t-shirt.
It's badass.
That's right, it is.
Is it the Pima cotton?
Nope, it's tumble dry low.
That's some good, that's right under, like Pima, tumble dry low cotton.
But it's worth $20, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's at least worth $20. You paid $20 for it.
I got it for free. Regifting. 20? 40? 50? 60? 80.
Oh.
And with an accent. I'm gonna let it ride right there.
Yeah!
$80 right there. Another question. Who's got another question? Who's got a microphone? Who's holding a microphone? Up there in the corner?
Hello?
Who's got a microphone?
Hello?
Hello?
Right in front of you.
Right here. Oh, hello. Gryffindor.
So, first of all, I'd like to thank you and all the nerds last year who gave me this shirt.
Did we really?
Last auction.
Nice. Is that mine?
That's yours. So, and for the $800 it raised.
Wow, 800? Wow.
Yes, because there was the bidding war last year.
I remember you.
Yes.
I love what you've done with your hair.
So it made a really difficult year really wonderful, so thank you.
Cheers.
My question is, rejection seems to be a major occupational hazard of both of your jobs.
Yeah.
So it's kind of for both of you.
Yeah.
Was there ever a point in your lives?
I think the rejection is just written all over my face.
Was there ever a point in your lives where you're just like, fuck it, I'm giving up? And if so, what? And if so, what? How do you deal with rejection in your career?
Alan, you go first. I just want to know. I want to, maybe he's got a better answer than me.
Honestly, like, over coffee this morning, I was sort of like that. I was there. I could be there at any point in the day. Anybody can. Can't you? Like, that's it. It's over. Nah. I'll keep trying.
Yeah. That's
there,
true.
There are inspirational stories, you know, that... And honestly, I was thinking about this today. J.K. Rowling, right? Wasn't she homeless or something? I mean, and at Comic-Con, I mean, it's all very exciting for everyone to see these big projects and all of that stuff and these fans and all this adulation. Well, if you were up for one of the roles on that panel and you're not on that panel, and you see it on your computer over coffee, you might go, this is bullshit. I'm not doing this anymore. Nobody loves me. J.K. Rowling was homeless. I'll be all right. That was how that worked this morning.
You get a lot of rejection. Somebody told me once, a very successful actor, when I was on my way to Los Angeles, said, can I give you some advice? Don't take it personally. And I said, that's great advice. And then I went to L.A. and I got a couple jobs right off the bat. And I go, I'm on a rock fuck it. And then I was unemployed for nearly a year, and I'm paying my rent on credit, going, I've made a colossal error in judgment, and I'm gonna go live in my parents' basement. And the rejection was, I took it personally. And I kept packing it down into a deep, dark corner of my soul. And when it felt like my soul just couldn't take any more rejection, I would just pack it down further. Like a time bomb. You can't take it personally. But obviously I never gave up, because here we are. Excellent question. Nice to see you again.
Yeah.
Okay. This one's gonna be a little weird. So I'm looking around my house going, I'm gonna bring a bag of stuff and I'm just, raise some money for Operation Smile. You know what, I'll give him this, I'll give him this. You know what I'm gonna give him? This is gonna be weird.
Please tell me it's not something I gave you.
No. In Canada, it's cold all the time, and we suffer from the occasional cold and flu symptoms. There's a cough syrup. The commercial is brilliant. All it is people on the street out, in the winter, and you see them. They're real people. You just see them reacting to something awful, going one at a time. You see all these people reacting to tasting this cough syrup. It's called Buckley's Mixture. Its motto is, it tastes awful, but it works. You have to be over 18. I assume no responsibility from anything that happens when you drink this. Do not operate heavy machinery. Or knit. That's weird. It works. It tastes awful. And it doesn't look all too pleasant either. $5? $100?
How much to get Nathan to drink some of it? We're at $100. $130 to get Nathan to drink some of it, and you'll end up with it as well. So, $130.
Sold. Should we? Sold.
Sold. Sold.
Sold on $130.
The seal is unbroken. It says shake well. Let's see that face that you. Can I smell? What does that smell like? It smells like Sterno or something.
It's like I kissed the surgical wing of a hospital.
Oh, that's nasty. Yeah, that's nasty.
I'm so glad you're here, Alan.
Wow. Who's got the microphone? You, no, that's not a microphone.
Left.
Right over there.
Hi.
Right over there.
Hello, Angel.
Hi. I promised my mom I would say hi to you, so hi from my mom.
Hi, Mom.
And I was just wondering what it could be for both of you. What was your aha moment when you decided that you wanted to be an actor?
Go.
I was in, the first play I ever did was at a community theater production of this thing called Most Fabulous Story, no, Fabulous Fable Factory, anyway. It was at the mall, yeah. And I played the jive talking hare. It was like the tortoise and the hare, but I had like a floppy hat on, I had a transistor radio, because that's how long ago it was. I think I was 11 or 12 years old when I did it. And all of my neighbors came to see it, the neighbor boys that we all hung out together and played together. Now, I was ripe for getting made fun of for this, absolutely, because I was way out there doing this thing that nobody else has done before, and I'm out there acting. And I got respect. Like, everybody was like, you were really good. You were really good. And I think that, from that, that was the first where I went, oh, I might could do this.
That's awesome.
And then my voice dropped, and a lot of amazing things happened to my body.
That's another story. I was fifth grade. Cam Germain was the class clown, and he was, I was in a 5-6 split, and he was in sixth grade, and I was in fifth grade, and we were buddies. He was the class clown. He would say anything. He didn't care. And he wasn't mean or vindictive or anything, but he was a clown. And he got sick one day, and I stepped in. And it was great. Like, I can do this. This is neat. Kids are looking at me going, you've got it.
You took over the class?
The class clown.
Oh,
job.
I see. Oh, I see. I see.
Yeah, he was the class clown. I just took over I stepped into his big red shoes.
I thought it was the teacher, and somehow he left, and you took over the class. And I was.
Was a movie you saw once. All right. I got this at Comic-Con, I think 2 years ago. I have a friend who goes off to Africa all the time, and she donates her time and energies to an orphanage in Africa with like 180 kids. And whenever I have extra clothes or anything like that, or just order jump ropes and different things that they can just hang out with and have a good time, I'll send it along with her, and it's great. So I was getting up a bag of stuff to send to Africa, and I said, oh, I cannot send this. But I can bring it to Comic-Con.
$206.50.
How much?
$206.50.
Sold. I didn't. Who said that, by the way? Thank you.
The woman with no money over there.
Yeah, why don't you round it down to 200 and just make sure you got, like, bus fare.
Yeah. There you go.
Beautiful.
$200. $200.
Who's got another question? Over there. Hi.
Hi.
I like your hat.
Oh, thank you. My name's JJ. I've actually met both of you guys before. You're awesome.
Nice to see you again, JJ.
Nice to see you guys. First of all, I loved you in The Waitress. That was the first thing I ever saw you in.
Thank you.
It was amazing. It was amazing. And, Alan, we got to see you in A Night Without Monty Python.
Oh, yeah.
And it was...
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
It was so great. So my question is for both of you. You guys are both unbelievable actors. You have such a great filmography behind you. Are you guys ever going to get behind the camera and do some directing or writing that we could take?
Alan's writing something right now.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
WRITE now.
That's a literary joke, folks.
Yeah, hopefully I'm... I think this year... I know this year... I don't know how much I want to tease this out. There will be something... I can say this. I am writing something. I can say that.
I once wrote a buddy comedy. I wrote like 3 episodes of a buddy comedy for Alan and I. I sold
it called?
To ABC. It was called Repo Brothers.
Repo Brothers.
Repo Bros. About a guy who like lost everything in the recession, the family business and all that, and he had this kind of miscreant ne'er-do-well brother, and as he's always bailing out of jail and stuff, and as he's watching repossession guys come and take all the stuff from his house and his car, he said, as long as there's suckers like me, there's always going to be guys like that who have work. So he becomes a repo man. But repo men are typically big guys who say, give me your keys. These guys are not those guys. So he enlists the help of his brother, who's a con man, to con people out of their things to be repossessed.
Yes.
So we're like pulling like James Bond-like missions. sneaking up on yachts in dry suits, taking them off and having a tuxedo underneath, attending a party with a little gift, put the gift in the engine room, pull a tag, and the smoke starts coming out of it. It's like, fire, fire, getting him into a life raft and then driving off with the yacht.
Yeah.
That kind of stuff. Hijinks, you know.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do it. Don't steal that idea. Next. What is this?
T-shirt. Oh.
I don't know what this is. This worked out really well for me.
Nice.
$50.
What size is it?
Good question, good question.
It's a Pima tee, by the way.
Whoa! From the Isle.
This is an XL. It's nice and soft. It's got that kind of thin, kind of comfy, cozy, like it's been washed a bunch.
You said Pima. We know that. That says it all. You were saying it worked out really well for you?
I did 2.5 days of work on that show, and I sent an email to Joss Whedon earlier this summer, just like a month or two weeks ago, that said, I just realized, Mr. Whedon, that I have spent more time basking in kudos of Much Ado About Nothing this summer than I have basking in the sun. So for my time investment, that was really good. How much did you say you'd give me for that? 150 over there?
It's an XL.
200
it's
over there?
XL.
XL. 300? $300.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say sold. Who's got another question? You do.
Nathan.
You, stranger in the crowd.
I know, because you keep standing me up.
Sorry, what?
I tried to see you at WonderCon. Jess said you were sick. I tried to see you at Philadelphia WizardCon, and you canceled. So what I'm wondering is, can I trade the $300 that I paid for my Nathan Fillion VIP experience in Philadelphia for a photo op with you later?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, you can. Beautiful. This is Tej. She's going to make sure that that happens later on. She's in charge. I know she looks like a street hoodlum, but she's actually quite respectable and intelligent. You're welcome.
Who has the next question? Right there.
Just got a microphone. Right there you are. I like your shirt.
I like you. And Alan. No, you're great. Thanks so much for last night, by the way, the Serenity get-together. That was amazing.
Oh, that was so cool.
That was fun.
And Zachary as well. I don't know if Zachary's around here, but that was in the Nerve Machine. That was really great. My question's actually on behalf of a friend in Germany, Nessa. As you said before, I think you know, you're huge in Germany, so to speak. Yeah. So this question is actually directed kind of both to you. You've mentioned before at get-togethers and parties, you've played mafia games, so to speak.
Yeah.
Is there any memorable moment from one of those mafia games or someone who's out of your party that's really good at it? Or?
Oh, yeah. I got a couple. I got a couple.
Go right ahead. Thanks.
I mean, I do, but I'm going to let you tell it. The one with Mr. Gunn?
Yeah.
That one, yeah.
James Gunn, okay? Yay. Very good at mafia. If you're not familiar with the rules, there's a secret team amongst a team. There's a bunch of people. There's a secret team within you killing you off one by one. And then you have a chance to try to, like, there's somebody among us. I think it's you. And you vote someone off, and they go, I was one of you guys, so way to go. Well, James Gunn was, like, the most incredible townsperson. He got every mafia player. He's like, you're mafia. And he tagged them all. He was amazing. And there was one mafia person left, and we couldn't figure out who it was. And the mafia is winning. They're killing us off one by one. We're going, who is it? It was James. He killed off his entire team to throw suspicion off him. Let my record stand for itself.
Yeah, that's evil. That was like mean. Some twisted. Oh, how do you beat that? Yeah.
And I have one other one. I attended a game with all these, it was a multicultural, is what I call it. 15 Spaniards, 4 Swedes, 2 Aussies, a Brit, 2 Canadians, and a Californian. Maybe there's two of those. It was a big game. Lots of people, lots of Spanish, lots
one
of these gorgeous.
One person from Pima. There was one person
These women, these Spanish women were so gorgeous, and everyone had an accent. It was so European, and all these men had these long, gorgeous hair, and I was going, wow, there's a lot of awesome, like, manliness going on in this room. One of these men was Antonio Banderas. Not a word of a lie. I'm going, oh, my God. That's Antonio Banderas. We're about to vote. Okay, let's vote on who's in the mafia. He goes, wait a second. Before we vote, I want to know one thing. Nathan, who do you trust? I said, oh, man. You sound just like Antonio Banderas. That was fun for me.
No, that's better than anything I got. I got that.
All right. This is a T-shirt. I've had this for a long time. It's got holes in it and stuff. It's a horse. But in spirit of Comic-Con, I'm gonna draw a little horn on this guy's head, make him a unicorn. Please entertain.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. Who here is interested in having a horse with a big cowlick on its head? I'm sorry? $100.
She can have the T-shirt and can sign something for
you. T-shirt for free. And you sign something for you. But you had said 100. So what if you did 100 for the T-shirt and then 200 to sign a thing? That's nice.
I know.
It's in the style of the artist.
So the T-shirt's going for 100, and we're gonna sign something for 200. Lovely. We can do that. We'll arrange that. All right. Who had a question? Who's it? There you go.
Hey guys, really appreciate you guys sharing your time with us.
That's, you know what? You're so great. Just to put things in perspective, last year we were here with the 10-year anniversary of Firefly. This year, I have nothing to go on this year. I got nothing. We're just not even here. If it wasn't for Nerd HQ, I wouldn't be here at all. So thank Zach, thank all these lovely people at Nerd HQ.
Yeah. Me too.
And thank you guys for putting in the time and effort. I know there's a big old Comic-Con going on over there, but we got some exciting stuff happening over here, and I think it's really kind of nice.
Speaking of Firefly, I was actually there last year for your panel, and I was waiting in line to ask a question, and I just missed the cutoff, so I didn't get to ask it, so I was hoping to ask it today.
Ha ha.
So it's been about, I don't know, 7-8 years since we last saw our Intrepid Heroes, and I guess I was wondering where you imagine Mal would have ended up 8 years later, and I guess this question's only for Nathan, right?
Not necessarily. Alan, where do you imagine Mal would be 8 years later?
Where Mal would be 8 years later?
Correct.
Probably mourning still the loss of his pilot. Definitely respecting his dead pilot's wishes not to touch his wife. Holding vigil for 8 solid years on some distant rock somewhere, just off on his own.
The one we buried you on? To be closer.
Yep, that place. Yes.
Weird point. That scene of your lovely funeral.
Yes.
First thing we filmed.
What? Really?
It was the first thing we filmed. We all went out into the desert. You weren't there. But you were there in spirit, my friend. Watching everybody coming out of their trailer in their costume for the first time in the desert, I'm going, wow, this is true. It's I missed you, Kaylee. I miss Kaylee. I miss Zoe. This is so great. I can't believe, oh my God, River's here. This guy. Oh yeah, this is Alan who? That's not true.
It's not true. It was a beautiful service. It was a very beautiful service. A little piece of trivia, my mother still cries when she sees my tombstone.
I would well imagine.
It's weird for her to see my face on the tombstone. Like,
how does she do with the bit where the thing happens?
He's fine with that.
Yeah, looks fake. That's what she said.
She's okay with the... She's okay with the death. It's just the memorializing that bothers her. I don't know why.
She's a strange bird, your mom. I have in here. Ooh, I went to London. I can't even remember what they're called anymore. The studios where they filmed Harry Potter.
Pinewood?
Is it Pinewood? Leavesden. I think that's correct. Thank you. Leavesden. Went there. There's two enormous sound stages. They have everything. Everything's there. They have the Great Hall. You walk through it. It's got stone on the floor, and it's really cool. It's everything's there. Wow. Went through it all day, geeked out incredibly, bought this. Later on, went to dinner with Neville Longbottom. Matt, who I met at one of these events, it was Dragon Con, one of my favorite events. It's, yeah. Someone's calling me. I'm just gonna turn that off. All right.
Gryffindor.
Where did y'all go? What did you eat? How was it with Mr. Longbottom? You guys are buddies?
He's like a young Clive Owen. He's like he wears suits. He's spiffy. He's classy. He's
I used to wear suits. It interesting. Mean and, you
know, he's athletic and sporty and classy at the same time. He's like you kind of look at him and go, oh, wow, Neville Longbottom. That's a stretch. Really is. This kid's a handsome fella. Yeah. He and his brother walk around just dripping with women. Yeah. It's weird.
Hanging out with all these runny women.
who'll give me $100 for that? $100.
$150.
$75. $200. Yeah. Let's let it ride at $200.
Let it ride at $200. There we go.
Another question.
Right over here.
This side. That when you say this side.
The other side.
Yeah, that still doesn't.
Alan's side.
12 o'clock. 1 o'clock.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm at 2:30. All right.
There you go.
Hey, I know you. Yeah.
I know you.
It's Rosie.
That's right.
Used to hang out in the bushes of the Jurassic Park ride.
That was me.
When we were filming at Universal Studio a lot.
My sister's here too. So
she's
also in the bushes.
Hi, little lady.
So first I want to say.
Rosie's in the movie.
I'm in the movie.
You're in the movie.
Scene selection 4, right after Jane says, let's be bad guys, you have to pause it. And there's a redhead in between Mal and Zoe. That's it. I'm also on the back cover of Done the Impossible. If you go to Amazon.com and look at the back, I'm there too.
You better be.
But I wanted to tell you guys, number one, and first I'm saying kudos and then I ask a question. Kudos, I've seen like totally everything that you have done, Alan. I saw Conception. Carol and I went to the Newport Beach Film Festival. That was hilarious. It's an independent movie. We saw Tucker and Dale versus Evil. Took mom to see that.
Nice, thank you.
Loved that movie. I went and drove far to Mission Viejo to see Beautiful Boy. Loved it. Yes, a hardcore fan of yours. I saw Much Ado About Nothing.
Finally.
8 times.
What? Because you kept falling asleep.
Because you... The whole movie is brilliant. I love everybody in the cast. I loved your performance in it. You were really good. My question has to do with, like, more roles. What are you looking for? What do you search for? Your like, IMDb is, like, all over the page in terms of what you do. So kind of like what your selection process is, or what you are looking for, or how do you get the next gig. I'm reading the Percy Jackson series so I can know what you're doing in Sea of Monsters that's coming out. So I'm excited for both of your work, and I thank you very much for being awesome. And this makes my Comic-Con perfect, that the both of you are here. Thank you.
Cool. What was the question?
What do you want to do? What do you want to do next? How do you see your career going? What do you want to... If you could...
How do you pick?
How do I pick?
How do you pick?
I don't know. I leave it up to God. I kind of... There really is a lot of just kind of... I go through phases of...
You just answered that. Well, you started answering it 3 times. How do I pick? I leave it to God. I don't know. You know what, when you take every, if you had 4 oranges, you know when you're feeling, when it's super hot out?
That's why my career is all over the place, because that is truly how my mind works. I just kind of go all over the place. I would like to write something. I would like to create something. I've always loved in movies. I love doing movies. I love doing television shows. I take a lot of joy. I mean, a lot of joy when my additions, my lines, my suggestions are used and are in the final product.
Which is often.
It is often. I have to say, it is often.
You come up with gems.
Yeah. We both are those types of actors.
I'm about 15% success rate. You about 98.
The neat thing about the ones that are in the ones that have been in the movies tend to be things that people come up and say to me and go, "Oh, I love it when you said this, or when you did this, or when you did that." And so, what's that?
Example? Can you use an example?
Can I use an example? A long time ago. I mean, even when I first started, I did a movie called 28 Days. There was a monologue about the fork and all this something about that. I made that up, that whole thing up. Look at my package from that movie. That was me. Knight's Tale. It's called A Lance. Hello. And people will say, I love that. Hey, hello. Bullshit. And, Dodgeball, Gar. They didn't write Gar once. No, I'm kidding. That's not true. But anyway, I want to write something. So I want to, I think it's much easier to add a line here, add a line there, and not create the whole thing. It's also easier to look at something else and go, I don't like that. I don't like that. I don't like that. I don't like that. I would do it differently. It's a different thing to actually do it. And I would like to actually do it, do something and see how it goes. And I will.
I would like to do something that you wrote or did. I'm actually at a point where a lot of my friends and people I know are building things. They don't say, "Oh, I'll wait to be hired by somebody." They'll say, "I'm going to start something and I'm going to build it." And they start saying, "Hey, would you like to be involved with?" And I already like the person, and I already like their sensibilities, and I already like who they are and the kind of people they are. So working with people you really enjoy, it's a very natural progression. And when you can do it, do it. So that's I want to work for people I like.
I got a script for you to read.
I like you. I like you. I have in here. This is weird.
A ball and gag.
It's my cummerbund from my first tuxedo that I ever owned.
Did you take this? Was this a prom situation?
No, my prom was like a tie-dye cummerbund.
That seems.
My grandmother was doing this thing, dyeing silk at the time with what kind of wavy colors. I said, "Can you make me a tie and cummerbund like that?" She goes, "Yeah, all right." That was my high school. But this is a cummerbund. It's mine. I can't remember the last time I wore this.
Did that cummerbund get you laid?
I don't know. It's clean.
Well, I hope you would have taken it off.
I don't know. It's kind of slenderizing, so you...
I'd leave it on.
Keep it classy.
Just the bow tie and the cummerbund. Just leave those two.
I think that's worth $20. Would somebody give me $20 for that for Operation Smile? $100? That's $100. How much? Who said 200?
Right there.
$200. I'm going to let it ride right there.
$200!
Who had another question? Where is it? Over here, sir.
First of all, I'd just like to say that Firefly is my favorite sci-fi TV show of all time. Castle is like my favorite TV show of all time. The writing, the pacing, the acting, it all is just so perfect. And on top of that, you find out when you read the little stuff on the internet that you're all just really nice folks. And it's just wonderful to find out that something that you really love, that the people who are doing it are nice folks. And so, anyway. And
thank you.
That's really nice.
My question is, when you're, especially after this much time in the role, do you ever read the script and you say, well, you know, Castle wouldn't say it that way, or Castle wouldn't do that at this point in their relationship, or something like that? And if that happens, how is that resolved?
First of all, Castle is in extremely good hands, right where it is. And I don't purport to know better than our illustrious writers. We have a very talented group of writers. It's a very, actually, relaxing feeling when you say, oh, you're good. You've got this. All right. Knock it out. But there are moments when something happens that a writer couldn't foresee. If there's a prop there, or if there's something going on, or if there's just the way the staging works out. And they're incredibly collaborative at Castle. We pitch things all the time. I'm going to say right now, John Huertas and Seamus Dever, I constantly have to remind them not to be funnier than me. But they are. And it's a joy when collaborating with those guys, they come up with the greatest stuff, and we do this great thing. It's a lot of fun to do on Castle, and you might have seen it. And if I point it out to you, you'll go, oh yeah, they do that a lot. Anytime we look extra cool, we make sure we get a kick in the nuts. Every time we get like two steps forward, we make sure. We come right back down to, oh yeah, just keep it humble, right? So anytime someone looks extra cool, they get knocked down real quick, like that. And it's very satisfying to play. It's really fun.
I also wanted to say, I was lucky enough to run into Molly Quinn on our way back to our hotel. And she is just the nicest young woman. She was just wonderful. I mean, some geezer fan like me comes up to her and says, oh my gosh, you're Molly Quinn. And she wants to talk.
She's a
wonderful.
Joy. The next generation of Hollywood is in the hands of the likes of Molly Quinn, I have hope for the future. It's odd because I have the sin of pride, like she's my daughter. I'm so proud of you. You just turned out to be such a fine young woman. She's great. She's great. You know, you've met her.
I have met her. You've done a great job fake raising her.
Thank you. Here's one for the ladies. I got this last year here at Dirt Machine, I think by mistake.
You wear that thing all the time.
Alan. It's a Nerd Machine robot nerd unicorn for the ladies. It's a ladies XL 5050 American Apparel. This is actually a really nice kind of soft little shirt. I will.
This beautiful for the ladies almost Pima shirt. Nerd Machine. Oh, yeah. How much do we want to say? Do we want to say $20 for this? We say 20, 16?
We had a 200.
200? Well, that just shut it all down.
220? There's 220 over there? Let's run it right at 220.
220!
Who had another question? Please.
Hi, Nathan.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Excellent.
So I've got like three more things, so we gotta hustle.
I got a lot of shit.
Like 6 minutes.
Good.
Go.
Okay. On Friday, Zach Levi called me the most vocal Canadian he's ever met, aside from you.
Right.
Right. So I was wondering if it's true, if you're loud, if you're vocal, if there's something that you are particularly vocal about. What do you got?
I'm pretty calm, relaxed, I think. What do you think?
Yes.
My sense of humor is I pretend to be boisterous and
yeah. If you walk your dog and do not pick up the poop, you'll hear it boisterous. But, you know, it's appreciated. Actually, when you yelled at that girl, not yelled at her, just got her attention and let her know that you weren't going to leave her alone.
Well, it got louder every time she ignored me.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. I think there was four people who said, thank you so much. Well done. Nicely done. Because she's supposed to get pick it up. I left the box in the car. L.A., 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 L.A. I love that. That is a time where your voice took you. You commanded the situation. You saw a problem.
Poop. Miss, please poop. Pick up the poop.
Please pick up the poop.
Miss,
yes.
Please pick up your poop.
Yes. Whatever.
Young lady in the pink shirt. Wearing the hell out of those shorts. I think people be pretty not thrilled with how normal I am. I don't know.
Yeah.
Hey, I met Nathan. He's just kind of, it's anticlimactic, really.
Yeah.
People say that.
I've never heard that.
I have here. Oh my God, I've been geeking out all weekend, okay? Jon Snow is walking around.
Yeah.
Lady Stark is walking around. The King in the North is walking around.
He was?
He was here yesterday. He was here yesterday. He was out last night.
Yeah. Wow.
What a kind, wonderful people. I'm a big fan of Game of Thrones. I'm going to be sad to see this go. I'm not selling it. Fuck it. I will.
And I'm going to sweeten the pot with a Wreck-It Ralph doll. Yeah. Oh, a little collector's Wreck-It Ralph doll that I'm going to put there from my bag of shit that I brought. You have a bag of crap, I got a bag of shit. And I will pick it up when I'm done. All right.
With say no action. Oh, Alan.
So for the Game of Thrones shirt and the
Wreck-It Ralph doll.
Wreck-It Ralph doll.
Who gives $100 for Operation Smile?
Operation Smile.
Right over there, $100. Well, the one I got, the one behind you in the dark blue. That's $100.
Yeah,
150. 150. Yeah. Any more? Any more? 150.
150. There you go.
Another question.
Another question. Right down in front.
Hey, again. Many times now. Okay, so for... Oh, dear. First thing, Mark Meer says hello.
Hey.
I know him from Mass Effect stuff that we've done. my question for you, and for both of you, really, I love all this auction stuff that you guys are doing. I think it's great that we're raising so much money for Operation Smile because I really believe in it. I'm a single parent, own my own house, have a full-time job that pays next to nothing, and I would love to throw some money at you if you will do Smiles for Smiles sometime today.
What does that mean?
That $20 photo op that Zach keeps doing over at the photo booths upstairs for like $20 because that's honestly all I got on me. So.
I love you. Yeah, well, I have two panels back to back, but right after that, I can go down there. I'm sure if Zach lets me, I'm sure that'd be fine.
I have to.
Yeah.
That was my goal for Con this year.
Let's make that happen.
Done.
Lovely. There's a site online called, and you'll do it with me? The Smiles for Smiles?
No.
Alan?
Gotta get on the road. I gotta get out of here.
That was not a question.
Oh, I'll be doing it there. Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, I'll do it.
There's a website on the interwebs called The Chive. Chive on, guys. They collect goofy videos and sassy pictures of girls taking selfies. And just funny pictures from over the internet and crazy stuff and inspirational videos that'll make you cry, stuff where the kids are showing off their musical talent. It's amazing. And they foster goodwill to strangers. Help out strangers. Keep calm, Chive on. KCCO, buddy. Here you go. Huge tips to waitresses. People.
Huge what?
Tips.
Oh.
A guy, there's a whole, like, you'll see a whole series, like 50 photos of people saying, here's some goodwill that I experienced. And there's a guy wrote a note to a fella, left it on his truck, and said, I was driving by. I saw you need new tires. Take this receipt to Joe's Tires on 53rd Street. Ask for Vince. I ask that you do a stranger a kindness, as one stranger has done a kindness for me. Here's four new tires for your car. Like, that kind of stuff. I really like it. So here's a Canadian, wow. Keep calm, Chive on t-shirt.
Four tires are expensive.
I know.
That's a lot of money.
Now.
Just got new tires. Expensive.
To sweeten this pot.
Yes.
I'm going to give you something else. I had these printed up. They're little business card magnets. Sometimes when you're out there driving around, you're trying to find a parking spot, and somebody's like done a really terrible job parking. And you just go, like, this guy is so inconsiderate. Consideration is a big deal, you guys. It costs us nothing. It's a super big deal. You're in a restaurant, turn off your goddamn ringer. Oh, I'll just let this ring. I don't care what anybody around me thinks. Just start thinking about the effects you have on the people around you. There's an immediate 10-foot circle. You really affect those people. There's a 50-foot circle. You have an effect on those people. The stuff you do during your day, it's a ripple effect. You can cause people to go, that energy's coming right at you, buddy. So these little things will just give you a little bit of calmness in those moments. It says here, it's quite possible you are a fine human being. And then the small print says, but you park like an asshole. Here's a little tip. Here's a little tip. If you put it on the back of their car, they might not notice it. We'll drive around with it for a while. That's from me to you.
Nice. So for the keep calm, chive on, do a favor, pass it on. That is, and then with that shit.
$100?
$100.
$250? $250 right there.
Can I?
Wanna sweeten it up? Sweeten it up.
I'm gonna sweeten it up. This is some shit. It's like, whenever you're doing a movie, you get like new versions.
These are goldenrod pages from Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter.
Yeah. And it has my name embossed on it. They make it like that so you can't give it away, or like, so if you leak it online, they'll go, who leaked that? Alan Tudyk leaked that. And then you get
it. Did you sign it?
I'll sign it.
All right, there's about 20 pages there, 15 pages. 250? We got 250 right there. Let's let it ride for 250. Oh, wait. What?
I said 300 if you're
Yeah, you did. But I, you know what? I already sold this young lady. I so feel so bad. I just I'm gonna let it ride right there. It's more important, I think, that you be happy.
What?
This bag. Really quickly, we got time.
$7,700.
$7,700?
Yeah.
Wow. Amazing, you guys. Alan, you and I took a trip one time, and we were in London. You said, hey, there's a con. Why don't you come down and do this con with me? I said, all right. So we did the con, and then we went to Amsterdam.
Yeah.
And we met up with a friend of yours. He took us to that beach place, the cool stuff. And
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
We walked through a flower market. There were tulips everywhere, and there was a shop that sold this bag.
It sold weed. And they also had bags.
This bag has been very kind to me. When it has holes in it, like it does now, I restitch it with dental floss, except for right now it's got some holes in it. I've carried this around for years. How long ago was that?
And why do you use dental floss?
Because it's the strongest thread you'll find.
Really?
Yeah. Leather? Just pack the crap out, it will never break.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was a long time. That was right after Death of Feet. That was 2006, 2007.
This bag's been with me a long time, almost 10 years. In it, I have my mini sides, the cover of my mini sides for Castle the other day.
Nice.
I underline every scene I'm in, but then I do a square at the bottom, a little eight squares to check off for I want to drink 8 bottles of water a day, so I'll check them off as I do it. So I make 8 squares, but I never check them off. But every morning I make the squares. I never have a pen on me.
And
put that in there.
Here's some pages, too.
Oh, good. What do you got?
This was some Superboy, Black Beetle. What was that?
Highly top secret.
Gum, Black Beetle, Whisper. What was it?
Young Justice.
Yeah, Young Justice.
Oh, I like that.
I was in that.
Michael Trucco was in that, too.
Yeah. I'll sign one of these pages. And anyway, this is one of those scripts. I don't know who I was.
$500 was, who said 500 first over there?
Right there.
Was you guys two right there? That's $500. Does anybody dare to go? I didn't think so. That's sold for $500. Nice work, you guys.
Sign the leather bag. I signed that leather bag up.
I'm going to sign it in black. What do you say, black?
There you go.
And would you prefer the outside signed or like the inside lid so it can classy it up? Nice.
Classy. I'm going to sign mine in silver.
I like that. We're out of time, aren't we? You guys, I know. 7,700 plus the 500 plus the 250.
34 smiles.
You guys.
Plus the 5,000.
Well, I think that's included. I think the 5,000 is included. Is the 5,000 for the thing included in that? That's right. You guys, 35? 34. You paid for the surgeries on 34 children. 34 children. We have 10 more minutes.
Right.
Good. Because I was feeling a little rushed. Who's got another question? You do.
Hi, Nathan.
Hi, buddy. What's your name?
Michael.
Hi, Michael.
You are really ruggedly handsome, Captain.
Can I say, I said that one time in the show, and then they put it into the credits, so it kind of became a catchphrase, although I only said it one time. For catchphrases to be stuck with, I'll take it. They sell that on a shirt?
Right here.
Oh, my God. Oh, look at you. I really am really handsome. And I think what makes it great is that it goes up an octave. I really am really handsome, aren't I?
Okay, two things. First, for $80, will you both please sign my girlfriend's Serenity
DVD? Yes.
Thank you. And second, this past Dragon Con, Adam, during the Firefly panel, had discussed an interesting story where you had told him he could keep a coat from Castle. And
yes.
He wound up getting in trouble.
Yes.
Such, and you were like, I'm on it. What props have you guys taken from movies, shows that you've been on, or have you gotten other people in trouble?
What happened was, I made arrangements for payment to wardrobe so that Adam could take home a beautiful coat that he was wearing. And at one point, they thought they needed the coat back from Adam because I had to wear it for another scene, but Adam had a much bigger coat than the, like, What's it called? I can't remember. They have a name for it, a French switch, or it's a Dutch double. It's like, hey, I'll give you my coat. I take off my coat, and I swing it under. I grab another coat, and I go, here you go, and here's a bigger coat. So it fits Adam Baldwin, right? So they kind of made a mistake. They thought they needed that coat back, and they didn't know that I had paid for that coat, and they needed my coat, but they already had my coat. Right. So he wasn't really in trouble. It was just a phone call saying, oh, talk to Luke. Red carpet Luke. You got to follow him, right? I love that guy. Oh, thank you.
Oh, good. Just do that right like that.
Alan, would you please tell the story of what you stole
from... I think you probably all know that story, but I did steal...
I love that story.
I stole the button from...
Out of gas.
Because it was only held on by putty. I remember sitting on...
Don't sign on my face, just right beside it.
I always try to pull the lids off of pins that are already pulled off, so I always end up with a lot of... Anyway.
It was only stuck on with putty, and you took it.
Yeah, I remember sitting on the bridge, grabbing everything, like, oh, this doesn't come off, and how's this held on by a bolt, and this doesn't, this doesn't. This comes off.
And the button in the show was for...
Everybody to come back for the captain.
Yes.
When your miracle
gets here... You press this, and yes. We'll come back.
Yes.
When Joss was trying to get Serenity made,
right.
Alan, in an amazing move, mailed him.
I brought
button.
It down. I actually went
oh, you
down.
Did?
Yeah, I went down. And although he wasn't there, I gave it to Gareth, the producer. And it was
I like that better.
For so long.
I like that better than sitting on his box.
Yeah.
Sitting on his desk with a little in a box that says, "When your miracle gets here."
Yeah.
You press this, right?
Oh, well, okay.
I love that story. From the same episode, I have the... Do you remember what I got?
The sister of that doctor. I've got this...
The catalyzer.
Oh, that's good too. Oh, that's right.
It's a nothing part unless you don't got one.
Right. Where does it fit? Ah, oh, that's such a good episode.
I like that episode.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really like that episode. It means a lot to me.
Can't wait to see season two.
Shh, don't tell him. Another question. We don't have time for that. We got to wrap it up. We gotta wrap it up. Smiles for Smiles at 1:45.
All right.
Nice work, you guys.
Brilliant.
Nice work.
Could you pass that? Hey, Rosie. Everybody stay seated. I'll come out there. Yeah, everybody just stay seated, and you're gonna be escorted out orderly, one row at a time. You guys are awesome. That was a lot of fun. And come to that Smiles for Smiles thing. It looks like we're gonna be doing it 1:45. All right, y'all. See y'all in a bit. Bye.
All right, let's go ahead and if you guys wanna pick up all your...